when I asked who's the woman who inspired them the most, they said mother. Shyamala here went one step ahead, brought her mother here. Amazing! She proved the statement. Shinpa is the evaluator for today's speech. And where is Shinpa? Yes, hi. Can you read the objective of CC3?
Hello everyone. Toastmaster Shyamala is attempting her CC3 from the Computer Communication Manual. And her objectives are select a speech topic and determine its general and specific purposes. Organize the speech in a manner that best achieves those purposes. Ensure the beginning, body, and conclusion reinforce the purposes. Project sincerity and conviction and control any nervousness you may feel. Strive not to lose words. Thank you, please, for inspiring them. All the best.
When Shyamala came here and spoke, I saw a child. Now she is going to teach you all. Keep the child in you alive. Toastmaster Shyamala, keep the child in you alive. Okay.
Shyamala, can you please grow up? You're not a kid anymore. All moms keep saying this, right? And my mom is no exception, honestly. But whenever I hear her saying this, I ask myself this question. What is growing up in real sense? Do you ever just forget to keep the child within us alive while tagging ourselves as mature? Because I still believe in my soul, I'm still that small child who did not care about anything else other than the colors of a rainbow and gave a wide grin whenever I saw my favorite chocolate. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and honorable guests. Childhood is one of the best phases in our life. And all of us cherish the small memories that life was carefree and simple. Kids and adults, unfortunately, have a different way of looking at things. I realized this when my dad told me something that stirred my thinking. We were in Baroda when I was in first standard and my brother was in third standard. We got a break of 5 days and my brother was very excited and my dad went and asked, "Arvind, what are your plans for this 5 days? And my brother said with a lot of excitement, "Daddy, I'm doing a chart for timetable for my class." My dad was surprised. He said, "What chart? What timetable? Did she give it to everybody else?" That's what my brother said, "No, Daddy, I volunteered it for myself. Because I wanted to do something fun and excitement, and I wanted to spend my holidays productively. Otherwise, I would get bored." At this point of time, my dad thought it was a waste of time, and my brother took some unnecessary responsibility, and it was a burden on him. Fellow Toastmasters, same situation, but the way my brother and my dad reacted to it was completely different. At one side was a kid who volunteered to prepare a chart himself because he wanted to do something exciting and grab every opportunity which comes his way, even if it meant a small thing. And then on the side was my dad, in the form of an adult, who did not have the same excitement and outlook towards life and things. He probably thought, why should we do when a lot of people, other people can do it? Toastmasters, sadly, as we grow up, we forget to keep up the same energy, same excitement, and lead a life full of zest and enthusiasm. How many of you observed? Even when I wished you a good afternoon, how many of you actually wished me back with the same energy and enthusiasm? Well, this proves that you have to keep the child in you alive to face life with enthusiasm. Now let's look at another example. Another irony is, the same guy who volunteered to do a chart now just wants to sleep and lays around when he gets a break from his college. What an irony, right? And another example is, when an adult faces any problem or a situation or failure, he says, "Hey, Bhagwan, why me?" And he gets tense very easily, and he doesn't want to move on in life, and he's just stuck up there. Probably because all of us are so scared to get up when we fall down. But when a kid faces the same failure or disappointment or a problem in life, he gives a pat on his shoulder and says, "Hey buddy, it's okay. There's always a next time." And he takes things very lightly. There are a lot of things we need to learn from kids. That's why we need to keep a child within us alive. I say, keep the childlike wonder and enthusiasm alive and stay young within forever. Probably, how many of you miss the child within you? All of us have a little kid within us, no matter what our age is. But somewhere, unfortunately, we got lost while we turned ourselves as adults. And somewhere down the line, we start missing that little kid within us. To enjoy life to the fullest, you need to rediscover the things you loved as a child. You need to keep the spark within you alive. Rediscover things you loved as a child. Be it collecting seashells, be it fighting with your sibling for that TV remote, be it fighting with your sibling for that one favorite chocolate of yours. Because there were a lot of things in our childhood which gave us immense pleasure while doing it. It is important to rekindle them. This speech is a reminder to ourselves that in this busy world of work and stress and cribbing about not finding motivation, if you just remember one thing, to keep the spark within you alive, to keep the child within you alive, you can enjoy life the way it is. I just say, be mature. Nobody's stopping you. But at the same time, be crazy enough to do different things and explore the world before us. Thank you, and I want to thank you.